Hi friends, welcome in. Today we are back to making a bunch of stock. It's after the holidays. I have lots of like meat leftovers, a few chicken carcasses here and there. So I thought it would be fun to make some rotisserie chicken broth. We sometimes buy rotisserie chickens, especially if we're going to Costco, because, you know, it's just fast, it's easy, we just spend a bunch of time shopping, and it's $5 for a chicken. That's really not a bad price. So I do have one, this is a rotisserie chicken from Kroger, and then one frozen Costco rotisserie chicken that we got a while back and I'm just now using. So let's go ahead and get started. This is, of course, the easiest part of the process. We're going to just go ahead and unceremoniously drop our chickens into this roaster pan. This is a 26 quart roaster pan. You might not need one as big. I went with the go big or go home thought process, and I've been really liking it. Now in this Kroger bag, I've actually added some chicken scraps. I used chicken tenderloins for something, and they have kind of like a tendon in them always, just to keep them together, and my family doesn't like to eat that. It's really chewy, it's just unpleasant to us, so I went ahead and added that to this bag for some flavor. This is a really great way to get the most bang for your buck. For that $5 Costco chicken, I think it was like $8 or $9 for the Kroger chicken, and honestly, we prefer the Costco chickens, just they taste better to us, so I probably will just stick with those from now on. But for that $5 chicken, not only did I feed my family, but we are now going to get several quarts and pints of chicken broth out of them, and then we can also use the bones to make bone meal for the garden. So that's really exciting. I love stuff like this. I love being able to use as much of something as I can. Now I'm just going to go ahead and cover this completely with water. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and call it there for the water. I don't want to overfill it. And I will go throughout the day, check on this, and top it off periodically just to make sure that water level stays high. If you watch the turkey bone broth video, I did not do that. The broth was really thick, but we also only got 4 quarts out of it. And I would like a lot more out of this. So it'll be less rich, but that's okay. And I'm sure you can see that this chicken in particular has a lot of meat left on it. This is the back of the chicken. This one is definitely more picked over. I think this was just from a night where I wasn't feeling like butchering the chicken fully. And so we just threw it in the freezer because we knew that we already had other like meal plans and it just wasn't worth it at that moment. So what I'll probably end up doing is after this is done, deboning it and everything, and giving some to the animals, the kitties. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and put this at 250 low and slow and let it cook for 24 hours. Make sure that it gets all of that good flavor. As you can maybe see, I can't tell. Let's try to bring you in a little closer here. Now I think you should be able to see there is lots of good grease and fat already floating on the top there. That is flavor. When I go to can this, I'll probably skim that fat off just to make the seal better or more likely to take. I don't want it to siphon and ruin the seal. The seal is more important to me than having a layer of fat on my broth. But while it's cooking, that will impart some great flavor. That's really exciting. I'm very interested to see how this turns out because I've never made broth with a rotisserie chicken before. I'm gonna go ahead and get this going, and I will check in with you tomorrow when it is time to strain and can. Hi friends, I really did not like the audio in this last bit, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do a voiceover. This is what our broth looked like after 48 hours, because last week was crazy, so I let it go longer. Here I am just going and straining it to make sure that we don't have any large chicken bits in our broth as I prepare to can it. I am just going through. This took a while. I definitely had to speed it up here. But I was really happy with how this broth turned out. It smelled fantastic. and I had so much of it. Here I am going ahead and just filling up some quart jars. I'm using an electric pressure canner. I know a lot of people don't like those, and that is totally within your right. I say do your own research and decide what you're comfortable with. I will be getting a pressure canner that goes on the stovetop here hopefully soon, but for right now this is what I have, and I'm pretty happy with it. I'm just filling up these four quarts. The amount that I strained out was almost perfect. And then I'm going to go ahead and wipe down the rims with some vinegar and get the lids on. Just real quick, make sure that we are getting a better seal. I did not strain the fat out. I probably should have because we did have quite a bit of siphoning. I'm just putting them in the canner now. These are wide mouth jars. The Nesco electric pressure canner can hold up to four, so I just went ahead and filled that up. And it's just a really simple process. I'm actually really happy with this pressure canner. It makes it really easy. You just fill it up with 8 cups of water, which is what I'm doing here. You add your jars first. And then it's pretty simple from here as well. This is me just trying to get the water off of the tops of the jars. Then you close it. You can see that I have the green valve on the back because of my elevation. I set it for 25 minutes and I'm letting it do its thing. Once it has reached the correct internal temperature, it starts to vent for 10 minutes. This is what makes it different from like a pressure cooker. Just like a standard pressure cooker is that it does this vent process. Here's after it hits zero. I then have to switch over to have it actually airtight. And then it will do this countdown just to make sure that it is getting to the correct internal pressure. This is obviously very important. You are pressure canning after all, and it takes sometimes a bit of time, and then it will start counting down as soon as it hits that correct pressure. After the 25 minutes is done, it automatically shuts off. You're supposed to unplug it, so that's what I did here. Just unplug it real quick, and then you let it sit for an hour. This also is what kind of makes it different from a pressure cooker as far as I know. I've never used a pressure cooker, but they are definitely different from the electric pressure canners, which is why I personally found this one to be safe to me. Obviously, I'm not a scientist, but after that hour, here I am pulling out our jars, and this was kind of interesting because I actually had some siphoning here that I wasn't expecting. And I think it's about to pop up. Doing the voiceover is a little difficult for me, I'm not gonna lie. But this jar in particular was giving me problems. You can see that is kind of loose, and there it goes. It just siphoned, just shot out. This did end up doing a good seal even with that, but I don't think I had the ring initially tight, or it just got a little loose or something, because it definitely moved there. But it did end up having a good seal. I did check it. Can lift it up by the lid and everything. It's all good, but it was really weird to me. I then went ahead and filled up some more pint jars instead of quarts, and the electric canner can hold 5 pints. So I'm just filling up those 5 pints now and getting those in, processing them for 20 minutes instead of 25 because they are smaller. And I was really happy with the yield that I got from these two chickens, and I'm really finding that I enjoy pressure canning, and just canning in general. It's been really fun for me, and I'm glad that you guys are here to go on that journey with me. This is everything after I was done. I ended up getting another pint and then 4 half pints out of that as well. So it was quite the haul of broth, and I'm actually making more chicken broth later, so I'm just going to be having a bounty of chicken broth. Which is really exciting, and I'll do a video on that as well because I'll be doing something different with it. But we got a lot. It was not a hard process. It is definitely time consuming just because you have to wait an hour between each batch. But thank you so much for joining me on this, and I hope to see you later.